Hey there, everyone. This is Michael Dougal, the nootropic reviewer. And while boron may be an effective natural testosterone booster, it as well comes with a whole host of side effects. And we're going to look at the four most common side effects that are associated with the consumption of boron as a nutritional supplement. We're also going to talk about ways that you may actually be able to minimize those side effects and the different dosage protocols that you may want to consider. If you're unfamiliar with boron, what you should know is that it is a naturally occurring compound. It's a mineral. It's found in water. It's also found in foods. They found that the average individual is taking something like 0.86 milligrams of boron from their water intake each day alone, and they're consuming an additional 2.5 milligrams from the foods that they're consuming. And in this chart here, we're taking a look at the different serving sizes of boron that you'll find in boron-rich foods. If you were to consume one cup of prune juice, you'd be getting 1.43 milligrams of boron. If you were to have half a cup of raw avocado, you would be consuming 1.07 milligrams of boron. And you'll also find boron in foods like peanuts as well as apples. And many people actually refer to boron as the miracle mineral. And we're continuously finding even more benefits with the compound for human consumption. In this study here, they were actually able to link low boron levels to a higher likelihood of experiencing specific types of cancers. And we won't talk too much about the long list of benefits that are associated with boron consumption. I've talked more about them in this video over here. We're going to address the side effects. And side effect number one would be sleep problems. And I was surprised to find that if you browse anecdotes online, you can find countless experiences about individuals using boron, either maybe not being able to fall asleep, maybe it's cutting their sleep short. This user mentioned, has anyone here have their sleep disrupted by taking boron? They're taking 6 milligrams and it's making their sleep completely restless. However, this phenomena is not actually backed by any of the research. And I've taken the time to look at every single boron study that was done on human subjects. And surprisingly, sleep issues were actually never brought up, or they were never found as one of the adverse effects during the studies. So I would look at the side effect with a bit of skepticism. Most people don't experience any sleep issues when using boron. But although it hasn't been my experience that boron has negatively affected my sleep, in fact, maybe boron has positively affected my sleep, I am consuming boron between 2 to 3 milligrams per day. And I'm not taking boron by itself. It's actually already in some of the products that I take, such as nootropic blends. It's in my multivitamin, and it's also in a calcium product that I'm ingesting. Something you may want to consider doing if you are experiencing any sleep issues while supplementing with boron is, rather than taking it at the later portion of the day, try taking it first thing in the morning, maybe wait 30 minutes after waking up and then consume your boron, and you may react more positively to it. The second side effect that may be associated with boron consumption would be issues with your estrogen. So if you're somebody that has any concerns about their estrogen levels, maybe estrogen levels being too high or being too low, what the research shows is that estrogen is likely to decrease when you're consuming boron. Although at the same time, there's research as well as anecdotes of individuals saying that consuming boron actually increased their estrogen levels. So this mechanism of action and this process is still being studied by researchers. And while some individuals mention that they use boron and they feel the increase of testosterone and decreased estrogen, some individuals mention that the longer they use boron, the more it actually increases their estrogen as a result. In this study here, which was done in 2011, men took 10 milligrams of boron for 7 days. And what happened was their SHGB levels dropped by 14%, their free testosterone levels increased by 28%, and their estrogen levels did drop. However, it would have been really interesting if they monitored the study subjects, not just when the study finished, but a couple of months afterwards to determine whether or not the increase of testosterone was significant enough to last, and if the study subjects saw any changes to their estrogen levels following the study. And if you're wondering whether or not boron supplementation will actually increase your levels of testosterone, I'm gonna say probably not. In this study here that was done on bodybuilders, they did see an increase of fat-free mass. They saw more strength at the gym, as well as an increase in testosterone. However, the individuals were using a weight training program, and there was no difference between the individuals that were supplementing with boron or supplementing with placebo. And I've tried pretty much every natural testosterone boosting product out there, and I can say the most effective one of the bunch has been Tonkat Ali, which I've talked about more in this video over here. I would use boron as a supplement more for general health, more for anti-aging, not necessarily increasing my testosterone levels. So the third side effect are skin issues as well as hot flashes. This is quite commonly experienced by women. In this study over here, they actually took women that were in a postmenopausal period, and they found that the majority of the study subjects did experience hot flashes during the night. And the study subjects were only taking 2.5 milligrams per day, which is not a high dose by any means. In fact, it's the common dose, or it's even on the lower side, because individuals are often taking 6 to 10 milligrams if they're using boron for a specific purpose, such as using boron for speeding up any wound healing or helping with pain. Overall, I wouldn't be too concerned about this specific side effect. And they actually did take a population of individuals that were consuming a very wide water-rich boron. And even though this population was consuming way more boron than they should, they ended up being just fine and no side effects were actually reported. And the fourth side effect isn't necessarily a side effect, but it's interactions, and you have to be especially cautious when you're supplementing with boron. And this is especially the case if you're somebody that has magnesium issues, maybe calcium or bone issues, maybe issues with your vitamin D. What you should know is that by supplementing with boron, you should likely be absorbing more of some of these other supplements you were to ingest. For example, when it comes to supplementing with magnesium, a lot of the magnesium is actually excreted through urine, but if you were to supplement with boron, it actually reduces the amount of magnesium that's excreted in your urine. And for this reason, you'll see a lot of different boron blends out there, or you'll see like a calcium product which has boron as well, because there's this nice synergy when you're mixing the products, again, for most people. But for those individuals that are more on the cautious side, they're already supplementing with something for a specific issue, then of course, be very cautious when it comes to supplementing with boron. And if you were to use the product and you have the capsules, most commonly you'll find that the capsules would be in 3 milligram servings. I think that's fine. I think a serving size between 2 to 4 milligrams is good. And you may want to consider cycling off the supplement, so taking it in a fashion of 2 months on, followed by 1 month off, and then repeating it that way. I find it a very flexible supplement. It doesn't matter whether you take it in a fasted state. It doesn't matter whether you take it in a fed state. I also personally don't think there's any need to take it before bed or first thing in the morning, because it really doesn't matter. And I really hope you found this information helpful. Make sure to click subscribe if you enjoyed the video. If you want to chat with me one-on-one, you can message me on Patreon, and be sure to visit our Discord server where we have a 24/7 chat room and we're having a whole lot of fun. And I appreciate your support and look forward to seeing you next time.